Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonzo. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 4th of August. High alert in India's Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan after heavy rains trigger floods. Taliban claims responsibility for attack on Afghan minister's house in Kabul. And hospitals rapidly fill up as Delta variant spreads in Nepal. And now for all the details. High alert was sounded in parts of India's northwestern state of Rajasthan and central Madhya Pradesh state on Wednesday as the Chambal River continued to flow above the danger mark following heavy rainfall. Officials in both the states informed that disaster management teams had been deployed and all assistance was being provided to the affected areas.
High alert was issued in several areas of India's northwestern Rajasthan and central Madhya Pradesh states as the water level of the Chambal River continued to rise on Wednesday following heavy rainfall. Around 40 villages in Rajasthan's Dholpur district faced flood threat due to the situation. Following heavy showers in Kota division, the Chambal River barrage was opened, after which water reached Dholpur, officials said, adding that the river flowed above the danger mark in the region. Rescue operations were initiated immediately to evacuate residents. In Madhya Pradesh, Datia district, at least 3 bridges were left damaged on Wednesday due to the strong force of water from the Manikheda Dam following heavy flooding. Heavy rains continued to lash several districts while disaster management teams were deployed to carry out rescue operations. Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan said that he was monitoring the flood situation and all assistance was being provided to the affected areas.
Because Chambal ka pani khatre ke lagatar upar badhta ja raha hai aur Kota barrage se bhi abhi pani chhoda hai, wo pani bhi jab pahunchega to ye water ka level aur upar badhega. Isliye Bhind mein aur visheshkar Murana jile mein nichle sthanon par jo gaon the unko khali karwane ka kaam lagatar jari hai.
Excessive monsoon rains this year have affected many parts of India, including Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra and West Bengal, throwing normal life out of gear. Seasonal monsoon rains from June to September deliver more than 70% of India's rainfall and are crucial for farmers, but also cause deaths and mass displacement across South Asia every year.
United States Army Chief of Staff General James McConville on Wednesday called on Indian Army Chief Manoj Mukund Naravane to hold talks on various key aspects of bilateral defense and security cooperation between two sides. McConville, who is on a two-day visit to India earlier in the day, laid a wreath to pay his respects at the National War Memorial in capital New Delhi that has names of Indian soldiers killed in conflicts with Pakistan, China, among others, inscribed on it. He was also accorded a ceremonial welcome at the South Block lawns, which houses various ministries after his memorial visit. McConville's visit comes days after U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken held talks with the Indian leadership in New Delhi. India drew closer to the U.S. last year following a deadly border clash with China. Washington has helped New Delhi leasing surveillance, drones and supplying cold weather gear for Indian troops. In news from Afghanistan, Taliban on Wednesday claimed responsibility for a car bomb attack targeting Afghan Defense Minister's house in capital Kabul on Tuesday night, which killed at least 8 civilians and wounded over 20. The attack in the heart of one of Kabul's most secure areas came during an escalation in violence by the Taliban.
At least 8 civilians were killed and 20 others were wounded in a car bombing in the heavily fortified green zone of Afghan capital Kabul on Tuesday night. Afghanistan's Interior Ministry spokesperson Mirwais Tanikzai said on Wednesday, adding that security forces' operation ended with the death of all attackers. Taliban claimed responsibility for the attack. Damaged buildings and vehicles were seen in the area on Wednesday. Acting Defense Minister Bismillah Mohammadi said his home was the target and that he and his immediate family were fine, although some of his bodyguards had been injured. The attack in the heart of one of Kabul's most secure areas came during an escalation in violence by the Taliban. Meanwhile, U.S. Special Envoy for Afghanistan Zalmay Khalilzad on Tuesday said that Washington has issued a clear warning to the Taliban that if the group takes over Afghanistan by force, it will turn it into a pariah state as the conflict in Afghanistan rages on, with foreign forces' withdrawal nearing completion. He said there must be a political agreement between the warring sides for a lasting peace.
More news from Afghanistan. Afghanistan has been the scene of increasing conflicts since US-led forces pulled out from the country in early May. Since then, the Taliban outfit has intensified activities that has forced thousands of residents to flee their homes due to escalating violence. Displaced Afghan families suffering in makeshift camps in northern Balkh province hope to live in peace.
Bibi Maryam, a displaced woman in Mazar-e-Sharif city, the capital of Afghanistan's northern Balkh province, sits in front of her tent in a makeshift camp with two kids. Her house has been destroyed by the ongoing war in the country that rendered hundreds homeless and left countless children orphaned. 37-year-old Maryam, who seems much older than her real age, said there has been gunfire almost every day in her hometown in Chamtal district, and she had witnessed the killing of innocent people and destruction of houses. Increased fighting between the warring sides has left thousands of families homeless, with about 25,000 of them settling in makeshift camps in and around Mazar-e-Sharif over the past couple of months.
و اثر جنگ بودن کسی نتونستن که یک زندگی خود بکشن زندگی به هر رقم تیر میشه یا یکم لیافی باشه یا یکم سرپناهی باشه فقط به حالتی برآمدن این مردم با یک چادر برآمده با یک پیرن جانش برآمده ما نمیفهمیم که جامعه جهانی و این کسایی که خود حقوق بشر میگه
Afghanistan has been the scene of escalating fighting since the start of the US-led forces pullout from the country in early May. Since May, the Taliban insurgents have intensified activities and reportedly has captured some 200 districts, including four in the northern Balkh province.
Moving on, protests have continued over alleged rigging in July 25 assembly election in Pakistan-administered Kashmir, the results of which declared Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan's ruling PTI party as victorious. A candidate of Muslim Conference claimed his votes were stolen and warned he will not let the newly elected assembly function.
Protests have continued against the alleged rigging in July 25 assembly elections in the illegally occupied region of Pakistan-administered Kashmir, the results of which declared Pakistan PM Imran Khan's ruling PTI as victorious. Muslim Conference candidate Saqib Majid Raja, who lost to Pakistan People's Party candidate Chaudhry Latif Akbar in Muzaffarabad with a margin of over 1,700 votes, claimed his votes were stolen and he won't let the new assembly function.
रात के अंधेरे में वो साथियों में मसरूफ हुए और साथियों के जरिए मैं 7 बजे से सुबह फजर की अजान तक आरओ के दफ्तर में पहरा देता रहा लेकिन फिर भी इन्होंने मेरा इलेक्शन चोरी किया तो मैं ये इलेक्शन हरगिज चोरी नहीं होने दूंगा आप लोगों का मेरे साथ साथ है
senior leadership of opposition, Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz, and Pakistan People's Party have also rejected the poll outcome and alleged irregularities in the election process. Locals have lamented that although Islamabad claims to have given autonomy to the region, the Legislative Assembly is not allowed to pass any legislation without its approval.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Nepal has been gripped by the second wave of the coronavirus since early April. Hospitals in Nepal's Kathmandu Valley are now filling up with coronavirus patients as the Delta variant spreads across the Himalayan nation, and experts say health facilities could be overwhelmed soon. However, to contain the COVID-19 pandemic, authorities in Kathmandu Valley have extended the ongoing lockdown till August 11.
The temporary shelter for COVID-19 infected patients at Sukra Raj Tropical and Infectious Disease Hospital in Nepal's capital Kathmandu has returned as a new mutant of the Delta COVID-19 variant is spreading in the Himalayan nation. In order to cope with the rising infection during the second wave, the hospital had extended its bed capacity by constructing a temporary shelter in its premises. With local administrations around the nation relaxing the prohibitory order boosting mobility of people, the infection has further increased and fear of the third wave is looming large. Experts have warned that the contagious Delta variant, which earlier had swept through the nation increasing infection and death toll, is still spreading amongst the community.
निषेधाज्ञाले कर्भलाई अलिकति फ्ल्याटिनिङ गर्यो तर त्यो सङ्क्रामक भाइरस समुदायमा रहिरहेको अवस्था थियो सङ्क्रमितहरू समुदायमा रहिरहेको अवस्था थियो र निषेधाज्ञा खोल्दाखेरि जुन हिसाबले मानिसहरू बाहिर निस्के मापदण्ड अप्नाएनन् त्यसको कारणले गर्दाखेरि यो सङ्क्रमण बढेर गयो हामी सङ्क्रमणको सङ्घारमा छौँ सङ्क्रामक भाइरस हामीसँग रहिरहेको अवस्था छ र हामीले मापदण्ड नअप्नाउने भने अझै सजग नहुने भने अझ धेरै व्यक्तिहरू सङ्क्रमित हुने देखिन्छ
The intensive care unit beds in Bir Hospital, Teaching Hospital and several other hospitals are filling up fast as coronavirus cases have shot up over the past few weeks. Nepal has so far recorded a total of 709,027 cases of SARS-CoV-2 infection and 9,922 deaths, which is more than casualties incurred due to the 2015 earthquake. Nepal last month also confirmed the presence of a mutated version of Delta known as Kappa variant. Meanwhile, authorities in Nepal's Kathmandu Valley have extended the ongoing lockdown till August 11 to contain the COVID-19 pandemic. The current round of lockdown expires on Wednesday and the three districts in the valley decided to extend it by another 7 days starting from Thursday.
The harvest season of aromatic plants that have medicinal value and can create a source of employment for youth are in full swing in India's Jammu and Kashmir territory. To enhance employment opportunities for the youth of the region, authorities have been taking vital steps to involve them in the cultivation of aromatic plants in the valley, especially the Pulwama district.
The harvest season of aromatic plants including lavender are in full swing in Pulwama district of India's Jammu and Kashmir territory. Farmers growing lavender were seen harvesting the plants, which have medicinal value that can create a source of employment for youth. Earlier, farming community of the region faced tough times with traditional farming like maize and could hardly make sufficient amount, but after the cultivation of lavender and selling the oil extracted from it, farmers of the region feel that they have struck gold.
अगर हम इसका तेल मार्केट में बेचेंगे तो 10,000 रुपए में केजी जाता है सर अगर सारे लड़के इस काम में लग जाएंगे तो किसी हद तक बेरोजगारी खत्म हो जाएगी हम इसको घर में भी उगा सकते हैं ये अच्छा काम है
आप लोगों ने घर में इसको उगा के रखा
है हां हां थोड़ा थोड़ा उगाया है हमने घर में भी लेकिन फायदा बहुत अच्छा हुआ
To enhance employment opportunities for the youth of the region, the government has been taking vital steps to involve them in cultivation of aromatic plants in the valley, especially Pulwama district.
मैं अपने नौजवान भाइयों को जो पढ़े लिखे बेरोजगार नौजवान हैं उनसे यही आपके प्रोग्राम आपके चैनल के वसाकत से बोलना चाहता हूं कि ये इंडस्ट्रियल क्रॉप्स है और इन क्रॉप्स की काश्त, इन क्रॉप्स की प्रोसेसिंग, इन क्रॉप्स की वैल्यू एडिशन से वो अपना मुआश का ज़रिया जो है अच्छी तरीके से तैयार कर सकते हैं, और ये जो है ये सस्टेनेबल क्रॉप्स है क्यों?
Considering the same, the government for the last few years has been trying its best to create awareness among the youth, especially the entrepreneurs who are interested in cultivation of aromatic plants.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/isasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @isasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.